High fly ball to center, and that ball's hit. Upton going back. Back to the wall. Home run.
No, he pulled it back. He took it right off the wall. The throw back to first, a double play. Oh, my.
Melvin Upton has hit a home run and has now stolen one.
Drake delivers as a drive to right field, hit deep. Back by the bullpen gate, it goes, and it is gone! Stubbs the right field to Johnson, couldn't get it, just to the right of the 380-foot marker. David Ortiz ties Mickey Mantle with his 536th home run. 10-2 Red Sox.
Here's the 0-1. Story hits it high and deep right field. Way back, and gone! Three-run bomb, welcome to the big leagues, Trevor Story. How do you like that?
I've got goosebumps.
Me too.
Not gonna lie.
Me too.
Mom and Dad are jumping for joy here at Chase Field. Wow!
Wisconsin night, but the roof is closed at Miller Park in Milwaukee. Tonight, the first of this three-game weekend series between the New York Mets and the Milwaukee Brewers. These two should be exciting to watch go at each other, and it's all coming up next. Taylor Jungmann will be the man on the mound for the Brewers. What do we need to know here, HR?
Well, Matt, he pitched into the fifth inning last outing. I think we've got to get more. I want to see more of this game. If he's able to go deeper, keep his team in it, and maybe walk away with the win. That's what I'm looking for in this game.
Digging in, the switch hitter, Jose Reyes. He enters play hitting down in the 240s for the year. Ready to deliver the 1-2. Now this pitch sails up and in, and that leaves him muttering to himself. It's ball two.
Pretty sure there wasn't any ill will behind that pitch, considering he has two strikes on. Just got away from him from what I can tell.
A swing and a miss on a ball way out of the zone, and there's one away. And now a chance to meet the Mets. Who are you focused on, Dan Plesac?
Yeah, you know, I love what the Grandy man, Curtis Granderson, does for this ball club. He's been the fire starter for this team. Last 10 games, how about an on-base percentage of over 400? As he goes, so goes the team. He's playing great ball and making things happen.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. One out, nobody on. On the ground up the middle, and that'll find its way into center field for a one-out hit.
That's a nice controlled two-strike approach. You cut your swing down, and all you want to do is see the ball and hit it.
Number 52, Yoenis Cespedes.
Here's Yoenis Cespedes, and he enters play today, currently fifth in the National League batting race. This is line to left. Braun is in his tracks now as he makes the catch for out number two. And he will scurry back to first as he'll think twice about trying to move up.
Center fielder number three.
Digging in, Curtis Granderson. He comes into play with a batting average in the respectable 270s. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Pitch is a cold strike. The throw. He's in there easily as the throw bounces on the way down.
I think coming into this series, they knew he was one of the guys they were going to have to keep quiet. But he's setting the tone right here in the first with the steal of second. He could end up being a big factor.
Two out here and a runner at second. And look out as that one ran in and got him.
Yeah, I'm not sure if that was intentional or not, but I do know when a guy at the plate is a stud like that and first base is open, there's absolutely zero reason to put the ball in the strike zone. I think he was trying to work around him, and it just got away.
In now, Neil Walker. And that finds the outfield grass for a base hit. Cabrera rounds third and is digging for the plate. And they're going to take a 1-0 lead as the run comes across to score.
Well, Matt, you want to get off to a good start? Right here they did. First inning, RBI single, first game of the series. This is a message, and maybe it's been sent.
Into the box now, Jay Bruce in for strike two.
That's a high strike on a curveball right there. If he continues to throw that pitch, we won't be mentioning his name very much longer in this game. He's going to have to get that ball down to be effective.
Time to take a look at the umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Mike Fillmore.
Now, Fillmore's an interesting case. I call him one of those guys that calls the corners. A little wider, but up and down, he's not giving you much. So if you just put a little...
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. Mets forced to settle for one here in the inning. We'll move on to the bottom half of inning number one. The Mets lead it 1-0. Noah Syndergaard will be on the mound for the series opener. Harold, any thoughts?
Well, if you're wondering why he's had a good year, it points to one number for me. They're batting under 250. Everybody, righties, lefties, switch hitters, whoever's coming at him. And when you're able to keep that number under 250, you're giving your team a chance to win game. And we'll see if he can do that in this one.
Stepping into the box, Hernan Perez. And he is proving to be something of a non-threat with the bat in his hands this year. The average isn't pretty. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And that slider's almost in the dirt.
Now that was a good pitch to lay off. When it starts on the outside half of the plate, that slider right there, you know it's going to continue to run off the plate.
And now this ball's lifted in the air down the right field line, but this will get back into the seats, so the count holds at 2-2. Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. In there, a base hit. Around first, he's digging for second. He hit the corner and tries for third. And he'll get there as he legs out the leadoff triple.
And the home crowd is absolutely eating this up. Let off the home half of the first with a triple, and they're applying the pressure right from the get-go.
Into the box, Keon Broxton. Here's a swing and a high pop-up. Drifting toward the third base dugout. And Reyes will take this one for the first out. And with that, time to take a glance at the starting nine for these Brewers. Anybody catch your eye, Dan?
Matt, I can't wait to see what Travis Shaw has in store. He's been such a consistent performer this year. And coming in, he's right up there in the National League leaders in hitting. I love watching this guy play. I hope he puts on a show in this game.
Ready now, Ryan Braun, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Well, no preferential treatment there. Sometimes we see great hitters have their calls go their way on close pitches, but not this time. I think that was actually a good take, but on two strikes, anything that close can go either way.
Standing in now, Travis Shaw. There's a swing and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. And this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. It's a two-run shot to straightaway left. Third home run for him on the year. And the Brewers take a 2-1 lead.
They tried to sneak the fastball by him, and like they always say, you can't sneak the cheese by the rat, particularly if it's up high like that one right there.
Into the box now, Scooter Jeanette. And he really thrives in the batter's box here at home. Something to keep an eye on in this one. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Line towards center field. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit. He has success with two out, and the bottom of the first stays moving.
That's a strong hitter right there. Slider in on his hands, and he still was able to muscle it out far enough for a base hit.
Stepping in now, Domingo Santana. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. But the Brewers do get two on this two-run home run. We'll head to the top of the second, 2-1 Milwaukee. Now to the plate, Lucas Duda. He carries a batting line in the 280s to begin this one. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Right over the middle, knee high. Now the pitch. Grounded to the right. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second.
Time for a look at the majestic defensive alignment for the Brewers. And yes, they are moving all over the field. They love to ship heavily into the analytics, and they really move players around playing the percentages. You'll see that a lot in this game today.
Stepping up now, Travis d'Arnaud, hitting a little over 250 coming into action in this one. A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. Line drive to center field. Broxton is there. Two gone.
Well, this one was squared up pretty good, but just like pitchers give up hits on well-executed pitches, batters make outs on balls they couldn't have hit much better.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. Takes a knee-high fastball.
Count is 1-2.
Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Drilled to the left side. Shaw fields it cleanly. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Mets go down 1-2-3. Our score remains 2-1. So coming to the plate, Jesus Aguilar, hitting just a bit over the Mendoza line on the year. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate. The 1-2 pitch. And a good sinker there gets him swinging for the first out.
All right, time for the majestic defensive alignment for the Mets. In this day and age, when teams are moving all over the place playing the shift, these guys are old school, very traditional. You don't see the shift applied very often to this club.
Here's the catcher, Jet Bandy. He's got hits in each of the last five ball games. One and one, here it comes. A fastball that he's way out in front of. A swing and a miss. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Line to the right side. But a foul ball. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. And a half-hearted attempt that time, but they'll say he broke the plane, and that's out number two.
For me, check swings are right there next to bang-bang plays at first as the most difficult calls for an ump to make. Taking a look at show motion, the batter doesn't appear to hold up enough, so I think the call was right.
Into the box now, Taylor Jungmann. Slow roller back to the mound. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for Milwaukee as they're unable to add to their 2-1 lead. Ready for another chance? Jose Reyes, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Fly ball out to right field. Santana has it in his tracks. One down. And with that, we give you a look here at what's happening in the race in the National League Central. Here now is Asdrubal Cabrera. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. Ground ball sent back up the middle. And now from the air, a jump throw. Throw got him, and that's a gorgeous play.
And this is not an easy play when you have the range to your right. He really didn't have a chance to get his feet set, so this is all arm. Nicely done.
Into the box, Yoenis Cespedes. He grounds it sharply to third. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Down in order go the Mets. They're down 2-1. Riding in once again, Hernan Perez. He'll start things out against Noah Syndergaard as this inning is underway. Ready on two balls and two strikes. Here it comes. And this is swung on and missed. Five quick strikeouts now, and that's your first out of the inning.
I think that curveball is a big reason why he's able to turn things around in this start after a rough beginning. It's got some good bite to it. So that tells me he's doing a nice job of snapping it off out front, really finishing that pitch like you're supposed to.
Standing in now, Keon Broxton. And oh, look out as he has to hop out of the way of the fastball there.
Hey, that's a good pitch right there. But you know, as a base stealer, when you're in the box like that, you want to protect your moneymakers, right? You don't want anything around your knees or your feet. So he was fortunate to get out of the way of that one.
Here's the pitch on 2-2. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Granderson on the move. And now a lunging catch, and he does a full gainer as well, but somehow hangs on for the second out. Here's Ryan Braun now, 0-for-1 here in the early going. 1-1, here it comes. Strike two at a pitch that catches the outside corner. A 2-1 score here as we play inning number three. That misses, and we're even at 2-2. He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. Gone in order are the Brewers. They lead it 2-1. In is Curtis Granderson, and maybe a little extra motivation for him here after being hit by a pitch in his first at bat. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. A fastball down near the shoe tops.
Hey, I appreciate the fact that he's making him throw a few pitches. Most of his teammates have been hacking at everything that comes their way.
And Granderson trying to work his way aboard. He's got it to 3-1 now. No walks yet. Here's the delivery. Hit sharply on the ground. Throw to first in time. One gone here in the fourth.
Now batting. Second baseman.
Here's Neil Walker looking to follow up the RBI single from his first at bat. Here's the 1-1 delivery. There's a knee-high pitch that catches the zone.
Well, he's pitching really good in this game, and the fastball location has been the key. That pitch right there is indicative of the game. Down low, hits a spot. That's what he's been doing with the fastball basically the whole game.
And he lays off the curveball, so it's a full count now. Due next is the dangerous Jay Bruce. Now a ball sprayed foul into the seats near third. This is pulled into right, and he'll lay out to make a spectacular catch.
Wow. Taking another look at it, the ball has some topspin on it, but he's on the full run and dives to make the catch. Nice defensive play right there.
In now, Jay Bruce. And Bruce will lay off that one. He's aboard. It's ball four.
Well, he loses him there, but that's just the first walk he's given up, along with a couple of hits. So his command has been pretty solid so far.
He's set. Here's the 3-1. And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
He did not want to let the hitter off the hook with two outs. And now he's got a runner in scoring position to deal with.
Fourth inning of a 2-1 ball game. Called strike on the inside, and he can't believe it at the plate. It's 1-2 now. Working for the punch out and the offering. Oh, and look out as this runs in and gets him. The second man he's plunked in this one.
Well, no one really likes getting plunked by a pitch, but as long as it doesn't do too much damage, most guys will take it any day. A free pass can be a big deal if the guys behind you can make it hurt for the pitcher.
Digging in for his second at bat, Noah Syndergaard. He's 0-1 thus far. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Good changeup that time, but he wouldn't bite on it.
Look, 2-0 to the pitcher in this situation with the bases loaded, you have to challenge him. Make him swing the bat.
The 2-1 on its way. Fouled back. One run, two hits, and no errors on the Mets line score so far. Again, he sends it out of play. Another try at 2-2. There's a swing and a high deep drive headed for the right field corner. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. A couple of walks, but no damage. We're back at Miller Park right after this. Trying to pick things up where we left off, Travis Shaw. And remember, he hit that two-run homer his first time up. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1.
Well, when you're behind in the count like this pitcher is, it's a good time to work in something off speed if you're confident in it. Most hitters are looking for fastball.
All even at 2-2. Here it is. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Bruce going back on it to the track, and he tracks it down. Nice play for the first out.
The second baseman, number 2, Scooter.
Here's the second baseman, Scooter Jeanette. A base hit in his first trip. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
He's going to be pretty upset with himself about that 3-2 pitch. All you want to do in that count is make a competitive pitch. That one wasn't even sniffing the zone, and he let him get away.
Oh, and they pulled the string on a good changeup there as he swings and misses, and he's set down on strikes for the second time tonight.
Well, I have to give credit to him on the mound for not letting that previous pitch get him. He wanted it, but he didn't get the call. But I love how he didn't let it affect him, and he comes right back with
it. Threw it right past him, a swing and a miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. Milwaukee leads 1. They still lead it 2-1. Ready once again, Jose Reyes. And at this point of the game, I think it's clear that the plan of attack against the top of the order has worked.
Well, when you've only surrendered one hit to the top three guys in the order up to this point in the game, you know you're doing something right, Matt. You're spot on. Whatever they discussed coming into this game has worked out beautifully.
Now some movement out in the Milwaukee bullpen. Both a lefty and a right-hander have begun to stretch it out. Here's a blooper out toward left center. Braun comes on and makes the catch in shallow left for out number 1. Tommy Malone is going to take over here in inning number 5, so it'll be a bullpen game from here on out.
Now pitching for the Brewers, number 33,
as Drubal Cabrera will be the first one to greet him, as he'll have to turn around and bat from the right side of the plate here. The 1-1 home to Cabrera. Takes a high fastball for a strike. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Here it comes. And the changeup is way low that time.
With the meat of the order due up next, you could probably expect to see something you can handle here with the full count as the two-hole hitter.
Line toward the alley in left center. And that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit. stepping in and ready for another shot. Yoenis Cespedes, 0-for-2 on his line thus far. Action now in the Milwaukee bullpen as they'll have a right-hander loosen up. Looks at a curveball called for a strike. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame.
He's gone.
There goes Cabrera. Hits this one hard the other way. And that gets through for a one-out base hit. And they'll have runners at the corners following the one-out single.
Man, that was a textbook hit and run. Right-handed hitter hits it the opposite way behind the base runner. They're first and third. They're in business.
Stepping in now, Curtis Granderson. Late swing and a ball line foul into the seats past the third base dugout.
He hit that changeup hard. Man, he saw it good. Just wasn't able to keep it fair.
Got
it.
Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. Ground ball left side. And a base hit as that'll score the runner from third and tie our ball game at two apiece.
Oh, they're playing small ball this inning, Matt. Back to back to back singles.
Second baseman, Neil Walker.
Into the box, Neil Walker. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field, and that is off the wall in right field. And the go-ahead runs in to score as they break the tie. It's 3-2.
Well, he comes up with the big RBI hit right there and puts them ahead in this ballgame. If they can keep a lead, get to that bullpen, they got a shot to win this game.
Standing in now, Jay Bruce. And this one misses to Bruce as he moves out in front. It's 2-1.
Boy, he better get it back together here quick because he's got two guys on already. He's starting to lose location of that strike zone. He's got to throw a strike right here.
And now this is smothered, but it squirts away a bit. Oh, but a comedy of errors here as they allow the run to score despite the botched squeeze attempt. Hit hard back up the middle, and that's through into center field. Base hit. Now a long throw home, and he's going to get in there at the plate to make it a 5-2 lead now. So another run scores there on the base hit. Their fifth run in five innings so far, and we'll show you a look on cue with the highest scoring offenses in the league. And you can see that the Mets are currently best in the senior circuit in that category. Here's Lucas Duda now. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. Santana makes the catch, and now they might be able to double them off at first. On to first, and they get the double play. So it's four runs on five hits, no errors, and no one left on base. Home half of the fifth coming up. It's the Mets 5 and the Brewers 2. Here's the catcher, Jet Vandy. He'll get his side started in the inning, and Dan, so far they've been stifled offensively since the first inning.
Boy, they sure have, Matt. They came out of the gates and got hot right away, but whatever was going for them pretty much has disappeared. We'll see if they can wake it back up.
D'Arno has a play, one away. Eric Sogard will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 18, Eric Sogard.
That's in there on the outer half. 1-2 now.
Frozen with a high fastball there. We'll see if they try to climb the ladder even more on the next pitch.
Weak chopper up the line, but it gets foul. We're in the fifth inning here. 5-2 is our score. And another foul ball.
That's probably not what he wants to do with two strikes right there with the fastball. He is fortunate he just fouled it off.
Cabrera there for this one at short. Backhanded. Throw gets him. Two down.
shortstop.
Ready for another shot Hernan now.
Hernan Perez.
He tripled earlier, making him 1-for-2 in the ballgame. The windup and the 0-2 pitch.
That's a ball.
And there's one well above the zone for a ball.
Well, it looks like he tried to waste one and get him to chase it. He didn't, but you're still sitting pretty. Now you're 1-2, and you showed him the high fastball.
There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. A leap at the wall, but he can't bring this one back. It's a home run. Shot here to straightaway right field. His first home run of the season, and it's a 5-3 game now.
When this one left the bat, I thought it was going to be an easy out to right. But it just kept carrying and carrying, and the right fielder gave it a great effort and almost brought it back, but no dice.
In now, Keon Broxton. Now a swing going, look out, over in the third base dugout as that thing nearly took out half the coaching staff. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And he's got himself another one as he picks up strikeout number 9 here, and the side is retired. But the Brewers get one back on the solo home run. 5 innings complete. It's now a 5-3 ball game. Ryan Webb takes over to start the 6th inning on the mound.
Number 56, Ryan Webb.
Here's the catcher, Travis d'Arnaud, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. And he takes a pitch right down the middle.
Wow, not sure what you're looking for right there, but that one was pretty much middle, center cut. Tough pitch to take.
And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. Here's the pitch. Now a swing and a ball chopped foul right at home plate. Now here's a check swing and they appeal down to first. No swing. So that's ball 4.
Now batting, the pitcher.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Noah Syndergaard. He's 0-for-2 thus far in this one. Now a bunt attempt here, and this is scooped away and stays foul. So now the question becomes what to do with two strikes. A ball and two strikes, here it is. Bunt sign still on with two strikes as he puts this one down. And a rather easy first out.
Up next for the Mets.
Riding in once again, Jose Reyes. No hits in 3 tries so far. He struck out once. Sinker misses, and it's 1-2 now.
Hey, I know you have to protect the strike zone when you get the count to 2 strikes, but on an 0-2 pitch that misses by that much, it's pretty easy for a hitter not to swing at that one.
Hit out towards second. Fielded by Jeanette. In time to first, and there are 2 away. Digging in once again, Asdrubal Cabrera. He's 2-for-3 thus far. Working to keep them in the game here. Sliced hard down the left field line. And that gets down and ought to be good for extra bases. And they'll extend their lead even further as the runs in to score from third. Now a 6-3 game. And he is into second base with an RBI double. So much of this game is situational hitting, guys. Nice job there.
Yeah, you've got to find a way to pick your teammates up when you're given the chance. And he doesn't try to do too much right here. He just takes what's there. Safely on second, and his buddy is high-fiving teammates in the dugout.
Stepping in now, Yoenis Cespedes. That's in there, and it'll run the count to full 3-2. And this one's chopped foul right at home plate. Another full count pitch home. And that misses ball four. So it's first and second now with two out.
Right about now, the manager's questioning his decision to bring this guy in. If you can't trust a reliever to throw strikes, you can't trust him at all. We'll see if he comes to get him sooner than later.
Now a spin and a throwback to second. Six runs, eight hits, and no errors on the Mets line score so far. And he'll turn and throw back to second again. The 2-1 now to Granderson. And that slider must have been low. It's ball three.
I'll tell you, it's a helpless feeling for a manager or a pitching coach when your pitchers are having a really hard time throwing strikes. What are you supposed to do other than keep trying new guys until someone starts attacking the zone?
Ready now with the payoff pitch. Now he lifts a high pop up, drifting into foul territory on the right side. And he'll get under it to put it away in foul territory, and that ends the inning. One for the Mets here on the RBI double. On to the bottom of the sixth. It's the Mets 6 and the Brewers 3. Here's Ryan Braun now. Been a strikeout victim twice in this one. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one.
That's 10 strikouts for him now. And I'll tell you, he could rack up quite a few more before he's done. Still a lot of game left in this one.
Digging in to try it again, Travis Shaw. He comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. Chopped weakly to the left. Throw in time as he's called out on a bang-bang play at first.
The second baseman, number 2, Scooter.
Ready for another shot now, Scooter Jeanette. It was a walk in his last trip. And yet another strikeout here. His 11th of the ball game, and this one ends the inning. Three up, three down for Milwaukee. They're still doubled up. It's 6-3. Back here at Miller Park in Milwaukee. Getting set for the seventh inning now with the Mets out on top. But first, let's check out the game summary through the first six innings of baseball. Your Michael Blazek is on the pitch from the bullpen Brewers. Now to start inning number 7.
Michael Blazek.
Ready once again, Neil Walker. Two hits and three at-bats for him in this one. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Takes a fastball on the inside corner. The 1-2 pitch. And he struck him out.
Up next for the Mets.
Ready for another chance? Jay Bruce. 1-for-2 on his line so far in the game. And this one's low here, so the count swells to 3-1. Here comes the 3-1 pitch. Takes a knee-high fastball.
Count is 3-2.
Here comes the payoff pitch. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there.
Baseman,
a 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that one too much.
Now a throw over to first, and the runner back safely. Runner at first here, one man out. Into the box now, Lucas Duda. Sliced hard on the ground, and that's through for a hit.
Well, the hit and run was on right there, and the runner running to second base on the steal. I thought he might go to third base. The ball ended up in the outfield. I guess he didn't feel comfortable. That's why he pulled up.
Standing in now, Travis d'Arnaud. He swings and sends it in the air to right center field. Dives, and he hangs on for the out. Wow. On to first, a double play. So no runs on a hit here, no errors, one man left on. Seventh inning stretch time upcoming here in Wisconsin. Mets out in front, 6-3. Now at the plate, Domingo Santana. He struck out twice thus far, so we'll see if he can fare any better here. And it looks now like a right-hander's begun to get loose in the Mets bullpen. Line drive to center field, and that'll get down in front of Granderson for a base hit. So it's a leadoff knock to start out the inning as they'll try to claw back at that three-run deficit.
First baseman.
So striding forward now, Jesus Aguilar. And he's likely just trying to put one in play here. 0-for-2 with a pair of strikeouts thus far. Heading out towards shallow right. Oh, and he botches it. Santana is on his way home. Now it's cut off. A throw to the plate. And they're not going to get him. He's in there at the plate. Well, that didn't take long to get a run on the board this inning.
Yeah, they made it look easy, didn't they? Leadoff single puts the guy in the stretch, and then wham, the triple chases him home.
In now, Jet Bandy takes a fastball on the inside corner. Ready with the 1-2. Now a 58-foot curveball that misses for a ball. Runner at third here, nobody out. Bottom dropped out on him, and that's a strikeout. And he makes the throw to first. Bandy is retired, and there's one away.
Good pitch there, and that was a nice job by his battery mate to complete the play first after the ball hit the dirt.
Ivan De Jesus Jr.
Looks like a left-hander has begun to get loose out in that Mets bullpen. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out.
Just tied him up with that last pitch. Pretty evident by the swing. Sometimes guys get in that protect mode so much that they're swinging at everything that they see, and they end up offering it pitches that they can't possibly do anything with.
Into the box, Hernan Perez. Now a ball pulled hard but fouled off to the left. The 1-2 pitch. And here's a ball lifted back toward the stands in right, so we'll try it again at 1-2. Again, a 1-2. To two balls and two strikes now.
When you talk about fighting, he's fouling balls off, fouling them off in a 1-2 count. He finally took a ball right there. I wonder if he feels more confident or he wants to keep swinging.
And he's going to add to the total. 14 punch outs now as that ends the inning. But the Brewers do pick up a run here on the RBI triple. 7 complete here tonight. It's the Mets 6 and the Brewers 4. Corey Knebel has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the 8th.
Number 46, Corey Knebel.
Michael Conforto is going to be asked to get things going here as a lead off the top of the 8th. Up high, 2-1 now.
And think about it. In game 1 of this series, they've already had to go deep into their bullpen. This could affect them for the rest of the weekend if they don't get really good starting pitching.
And this is on the inside edge, perhaps off the inside edge, but it's a called strike, 2-2 now. swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. He takes the turn and heads for second. And he will coast into second with a leadoff double.
When you're leading by one run, you want to do everything you can to add to the lead to give your bullpen a little breathing room. It makes a big difference. So double here goes a long way towards making that a real possibility.
Into the box now, Jose Reyes. In the dirt here. And he'll rein it in as the count moves to 1-2. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. And he's bunting with two strikes, but can't connect, so a real wasted at bat there.
The shortstop, number 13.
Here now is his Drupal Cabrera. He's got three hits, including a double to this point. One out and a runner on second base. Squared that one up just a little late.
Well, I think he's trying to get that two-strike fastball out of the zone. Just caught too much of the plate right there. Fortunately, he fouled it off instead of putting it in the seats.
And a neck-high fastball that time.
Looked like he just tried to do too much with that fastball right there. He overthrew it a little bit. That's pretty much the case when you airmail a fastball like that.
Rips this one to first. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield. Conforto rounds the corner and is headed home. Throw won't get him.
Well, that's a big base hit right there. Now you got a three-run lead. You always play to beat that bloop and that blast that can hurt you late in the game. And now they've got that cushion.
Standing in now, Yoenis Cespedes. He offers at it and hits it in the air to left. Braun will get there with ease as he puts it away for out number two.
Center fielder number three.
At the plate, Curtis Granderson. In his last at-bat, he popped out in foul ground. Now a pickoff play at second. Now a spin and another throw back to second. Getting a few steps off a second there. Now the pitch. In there, and it's even now, 2-2.
I don't know about his decision not to swing there. Hitters count, you get a fastball middle in. That's the one you drive out of the ballpark.
A throw behind the runner at second. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's throwing a bunch of
hits. A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Well, the run will score in the inning on this RBI double. On now to the bottom of inning number eight. It's the Mets 7 and the Brewers 4. Addison Reed is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 43, Addison Reed.
And that'll bring in the speedy Keon Broxton. No hits in three tries so far. He's struck out once. Here's the 1-1. Boy, good bite on the slider, and it just missed inside. A slider that he looks at over the outside corner.
Great spot with that pitch down and away. He'll be fine coming out of the bullpen in this one if he can keep hitting that spot.
And this is fouled back and out of play. The pitch. Fastball is outside. It's full now. 3-2. On deck, the always dangerous Ryan Braun. Got him on a good slider there. Swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight. Now at the plate, Ryan Braun. Three at-bats for him in this one, all ending with him going down on strikes. Skied into straightaway right. And Bruce has got this one two away now.
The batter.
And that brings up the left-handed hitting Travis Shaw. Two away here in the eighth, and time's running out on him, Danny.
Yeah, they don't have a lot of outs left to work with, so it's time for someone to make something happen if they're going to get back into this thing.
A good knee-high changeup taken for a strike. Reed's ready. Here's the 1-2. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. Two out, nobody on. Hit down the line at first, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Here's the 1-2. Fastball stays way up that time for ball two. Now here's the pitch. And strike three called as he says, you got to be kidding me, with the side retired. Gone in order are the Brewers. They're on the short end of a 7-4 score. Jabba Chamberlain enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Here's Neil Walker. On the night, he's 2-for-4 with a pair of singles. Walker lays off there. It's two balls and a strike. Fastball, and looks like they're pinching him a bit here. It's 3-1.
Well, it's a pretty well-known fact that your batting average goes up as you get into more favorable hitters counts, and that's especially true when we're talking about this kind of hitter. Not a great spot to be in if you're the pitcher.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. Swing and a little blooper to center. And he will make the catch on the full run. And there's a dandy of an out to start the inning.
Right fielder.
Digging in, Jake Bruce. He singled in two trips to the plate thus far. He's set, and the 1-2 pitch. Hot shot down the line. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Now another 1-2. And a fastball just a bit up. And a swing and a miss here, and the first two are dispatched to begin the ninth. Here's Lucas Duda now. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. The 2-1 on its way. Hit back up the middle. Perez scoops it up. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Mets go down 1-2-3. They hold a 7-4 lead. Jerry Spamilia takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door.
Jerry Spamilia.
Striding in, Scooter Jeanette. He'll lead it off against Jerry Spamilia, who'll try to close the door in this one. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Ball and two strikes. Here it is. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Throw on to first in time. One away. So the leadoff man gone to start the top of the ninth as we take a look at league saves leaders entering play. And as you see, he's right up there among league leaders in that department. Coming to the plate now, Domingo Santana. He singled his last time up. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Got a big pass at a slider that gets past him. Here's the 1-2 delivery. And that slider's almost in the dirt. And the slider stayed low apparently for a ball. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. The 3-2 one more time. He spoils another one, and will do it again. Full count, here it comes. Swing and a liner. And that's in for his second hit of the afternoon.
Well, that's a good sign for him right there. A single hard hit. That's his second hit of the game. Now, he's been hitting in the 220 so far most of the season. Maybe this is the start of good things for him ahead.
In now, Jesus Aguilar. As he loops under the ball and pops it up, Darno has a play. Makes the play, and there are two gone now. At the plate, Jet Bandy, 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ballgame is over.
Yeah, that's what you want to do when you're playing on the road. Take it right to the home squad and get a win. Now the pressure's off. If they get one of the next two, the series is theirs.
Seven to four is the final score in tonight's game. Noah Syndergaard earned his fifth win of the year, racking up 14 Ks in doing so. Jerry's Familia wraps it up for the save, his 11th of the campaign. So that just about does it. For Harold Reynolds, Dan Plesac, and our crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, final make your way on over to theshownation.com.
For the victorious New York Mets, 7 runs, 11 hits, no errors. They left 11 men on.
Cologne looking for his first hit of the year. Oh. He drives one deep left field. Back goes Upton. Back near the wall. It's out of here. Bartolo has done it. The impossible has happened. This is one of the great moments in the history of baseball. Bartolo Cologne has gone deep.
Here's the 0-2. Swung on. There goes the deep left. It is high. It is far. It is gone. He's done.